Good evening, Miranda. Can you hear me? Okay, thank you. Thanks for the confirmation. Very good evening, very good. Still some students not joined. Only 100 students are there currently. Start the class. Whether they will join or not, I don't know. Let me complete my task. So actually, I have given an yesterday and one assignment question regarding finding the second largest and second smallest. And I thought that still many students are using sort method. So even though I have given an instruction in that question itself, you don't use a predefined function or methods. So that means you don't want to use sort method, okay? But still some students submitted the same. Don't do like that, guys, please, okay? So yesterday I have given a how to perform, find how to find out the smallest and largest number using if conditions, nested if I am using, right? So I think many students are still confusing how to find the sorting. That means if you without sort method, how can we sort the program? That means for how can you sort the elements? So if you know that, I think you're easily you can do. That means that can be, actually I thought that some students may like they will use if else statement, but only out of all the submissions of assignments, only one student submitted with if else statement, Ms. Bhavani, I think, okay? So please guys, once again, I'm advising you, I don't want to reveal with if conditions because so in Python, we can easily define 1 minute. Let me check with October 8 or October 7. Okay. So this is the last day I have explained this, right? So for example, some students are doing that simply they are getting sort method. And after that, whatever the value in the first element, that should be A of 0. And I'm asking the second largest. If it is largest, then you are giving like A of N minus 1. Yes. So if it is second largest, what we have to do, guys? Second largest. The second smallest in the sense, we can access from A of 1, right? A of 0 and A of 1. A of 0 is smallest, A of 1 is second smallest. Yes, everybody should respond. Only Priyanka responded till now. What happened, guys? Why are you so dull? I think you want holidays. Navya, no, that is wrong answer, Navya. I'm asking that, okay, once again I'm telling you, if you would like to find out the second largest from the list, you can access from right to left, yes? Yes, yes, yes. You can do in two ways. You can do in two ways. A of minus 2 or A of N minus 2. Okay? Don't use sort method. Once again I'm telling you, Monica. Okay. Okay, then I will tell you first. So how to do sorting? Because there is no sorting concepts in our syllabus itself, you know, guys. But even though in the syllabus they did not mention, why I am telling maximum, minimum, and because it is a part of the list, of course, yes. So because almost I am covering all the topics, you know, because we already entered into the almost in the 99% we completed the third unit. Okay, so that's the reason I would like to take an example, because many students submitted, not only one or two, many students submitted by using sort function only. Okay, so I thought that you can use if else also. By using if else also you can do, but it is somewhat critical. Okay, somewhat, that's all. Okay, but if you want to do with the sorting, you just try with the sorting logic in a different way. Like you can do in whatever the sorting you have in DS, you already studied, like bubble sort, selection sort, or whatever it may be. I think many of the students are telling that bubble sort is easy. Okay, let me take that example today. Okay, so I don't want to take all the examples like merge sort and heap sort and all. Okay, I'm telling for only for sorting we need one algorithm. Okay, so now I would like to explain bubble sort. So still some students are not joined. What happened, guys? So I think many of the students know what is a bubble sort. Let me open the notes. So this is called bubble sort. Okay, so don't use sort method and all. And one point I would like to mention yesterday, actually I forgot that. Actually let me tell one thing. I explained the differences between sorted and sort method. I have already explained, but I would like to tell one more thing, guys. I'm just removing this. So before going to the explaining about the bubble sort, I will tell you about sort method. Sort. 1 minute. Let me run this first. I will give some elements. Okay, I have given 4 elements. What is this? You can directly give sorted number dot sort. 1 minute. Let me give. After that, I will give print number. Okay. Okay. So you're taking less. Here I'm getting 4, 45, 54, and 87. So this is the output for sorting the given numbers. Okay. Here I'm removing square bracket. I'm adding tuple. I'm adding tuple here. Okay. I'm getting error. What is this error? So can you find out this? So because why it is getting like this, this sort method can be applicable for only list elements. That is the point I would like to tell you guys. Okay, so now I'm running the program. So it is getting tuple object has no attribute sort. Okay, it is clearly telling that tuple, that means we are having a tuple data type, in that there is no sort method. That's the reason in yesterday I have shared the material. You can check in the material also, Python list sort. I have given the heading like that. Why? Because, so actually I forgot to tell that concept actually. Okay, so that means list, this sort method only applicable for list. If any interviewer asking like what is the difference between a sort and sorted method, sorted function can be applicable for all the data types. You already explained different types, like in the last class I have given dictionary, set and all. I have compared with sorted function by using that, right? But sort can be applied for only list elements. Okay, so you should understand when I'm changing square bracket, now I will get the output. Now I will get the output. So this is the major thing. This is also the very important entry question, guys. So you should remember. Okay, so now let me move to the quick fast. So still 150 plus, what happened, guys? So is it exam fever? I think so. Many students are absent. So anyway, okay. So 1 minute, guys. So what is a bubble sort? So I will tell you one sorting technique. Okay. So bubble sort means it is like a sinking sort. So sinking means it's like a just like jumping. Okay. So it is a simple sorting algorithm that repeatedly steps through the list, compares adjacent elements and swaps them if they are in the wrong order. Okay, so don't use predefined method sorts, while especially you're doing like the example what I have given yesterday. Okay, so I will tell you, I think many of the students know about bubble sort, but sorting also very important. And once again, I'm telling, sorting means whether the list can be, you can print in the ascending or descending order, nothing but, okay, so sort. So let me move with the bubble sort PPT. I would like to present a small PPT for your understanding purpose. Is this topic completed? Second year students, can you please respond? In DS subject, we completed bubble sort technique. Wow, super. Thank you. Thank you, Ambika Pravalika, Venkatrao. Andra, thank you very much, Andy. Okay, fine. So many of the students are telling that, yes, I think they know, right? But still I have to tell, because my teaching is entirely different, okay? So, you know, let me open bubble sort. So first I will tell the what is a bubble sort. First, I'm taking the list here. Sorting takes an unordered collection and make it as an ordered one. This is nothing but a sorting, okay? That means I am taking a list. So with 77, 42, 35, 12, 101, 5. These are the elements, guys, okay? So before going to write the logic, you have to understand what the concept first. So sorting and searching are very beautiful things in data structures, okay? So you will get the marks very easily in interview point of view. So these are very important, especially time complexities, okay? So anyway, I don't want to discuss much about data structures. So 1 minute, and yeah, here I'm taking 77, 42, 35, and 12, 101, 5. So here you can see, after sorting, you have to get the list like 5, 12, 35, 42, 77, 101, okay? So total 6 elements we have. According to index, we have to start from 0 only, but I'm telling only the elements order only, I'm telling, okay? So now you can see here, okay, you just see here. 1 minute, guys. Okay. Bubbling up the largest element. That means here. 1 minute, guys. Is my internet working? Oh, let me check it once. Okay, fine. Okay. So here it will traverse the, move from the front to the end, bubble the largest value to the end using pairwise comparisons and swapping. So here the whatever the list I am having, so that I'm displaying those list elements. So 77, 42, 35, 12, and 101 and 5. So let me take drawing tools. I forgot actually. So let me take drawing tools. In PPT, is it possible or I don't know? Let me check, no problem. So okay, fine. So it is getting no problem. Okay. So here you can see, you should compare the first element with an adjacent element. That is called bubble sort, okay? That means first you have to compare 77 with 42. So which one is greater than, that means 77 is greater than 42. Whenever 77 is greater than 42, then you have to shift the 77 to second position. That means this is the second position. And you have to traverse through the 42 in this position, okay? So let me run it. Here I'm telling now. One minute, guys. Sometimes it is stopping actually. Okay. So I am highlighting this. You can see it is comparing 77 with 42. So 77 is greater than 42. Then you need to swap. Then 42, 77. This is the first step. After that, you should compare 77 with 35. Okay. After you should compare with 77 with 35. Then 77 is also greater than 35. That means you have to swap 35. 77 in those positions, okay? So now it will be 35 and 77. Now again, you have to check 77 with 12, okay? Then it will be 77 is greater than 12. This is also condition true. Now you have to swap the 77 with 12, okay? Now it is in the correct position. Now I am giving 77 with 101. So now it is in the correct order. So no need to swap. Here you need to swap, guys. And you want to compare with 101 with 5. Okay, so whenever you're comparing 101, 5, you need to swap again. Okay, so then it becomes 5, 101. So whenever the first iteration is completed, the largest element will be bubbling to the end. This is called bubble sort. okay, bubbling up the largest element. This is the heading actually. So you can see, compared to the given list, now 101 is the largest value. You can end the first iteration. Okay. Now what we have to do? Then we have to left with 101. That means you can take the remaining list 42, 35, 12, 77, 5. That means you have to take those 5 elements, and again you have to compare 42 and 35. Okay. So in that way you need to traverse. Okay. Largest value will be correctly placed now. So now you can check the process repeatedly. So notice that only the largest value is correctly placed. All other values are still out of order because remaining elements are not in the correct order. So we need to repeat this process again. Okay. So how many times you want to repeat this value? So actually, if you are having n elements, you have to bubble up to n minus 1 times. Because when you are seeing the above example, okay. So how many times you are iterated the value? That means n minus 1. You can check also, no problem. And let me take the value now. So this is the list I have taken, and the first iteration 101 is placed in that element. Okay. So after that second iteration, that means I'm moving up. Okay, because you already know that the first element how 101 is placed into the last position. In that way, you have to check with 42 with 35, and 42 is greater than 35. Then 42 will be traversed to the second position, and again you have to compare with 42 with 12, and it is also condition true. Now you have to swap, then 12, 42, and 42 with 77, then 77 will be moved to the last, that means 77, 42, 77 is the correct order, okay? You don't need to swap. And 77, 5 is the wrong order, that means 77 is greater than 5. So then you need to swap. Then it will be go to the 77 in the correct position. So in this way, so your elements will be like this, okay? That means after completion of all the steps, you will get the order, sorted order like this, okay? So this is called bubble sort, guys. This is called bubble sort. Total we have n minus 1 steps, okay? For every iteration, and I would like to tell you one more thing, you have to left with the last element. Once again, I'm telling. That means, for example, I'm showing the one more thing, PPT, okay? So if I'm in the first iteration, 101 is going to the end position, you can left with 101, you can take the remaining list. After 77 is getting, you have to take the remaining 4 elements. Then after 42 also, you're getting the largest value like this. Then you have to take the remaining 3 elements, okay? So here, you can see, if you are taking the 6 numbers, your loop will be iterated n minus 1 times. But here, whenever you are iterating the nest, means you want to use the nested loop concept here. So, and in the nested loop concept, so in the nested loop, that means whatever the inner loop you are having, in that you no need to check the last element again and again. That means you have to check minus 1 again. Okay, so this is the just a PPT for bubble sort. I hope you understand now. And if you want any more clarity, I will. So here I'm giving you one more example in notes because I don't want to send a PPT, okay? So I always use it to send the material, right? So in that time I have given a different example, but definitely you can understand definitely. I'm telling one more time anyway. So I'm taking minus 2, 45, 07 and minus 9. This is the list we have, okay? So after sorting, the list is ordered here, okay? So in bubble sort, here it is taking 4 steps. That means for 5 elements, it is taking 4 steps, okay? So that means n minus 1. Just now I explained why it is there, okay? So first it will check minus 2 and 45. So minus 2 and 45, it is not correct order, okay? So you no need to swap anything. And 45, 0, now it is wrong position. So you need to swap this, okay? 45, 0. 45 is greater than 0, that's the reason it is like this, okay? So 45 with 11 and 45 with minus 9. And minus 9 with 41, that means here you, after traversing this value, 45 is getting the last position, guys. Okay. Then you have to move, then you have to remove 45. Then you can do the remaining elements. You can do like this. Okay. Here, last element cannot be compared. You can check here. Okay. After that second iteration, you will get the 2 elements in the last position in the correct position. Okay. So you can left in this way. Okay. So now I will move the program. How to write a program, I will tell you. Yesterday also I had discussed about this. So I'm just giving the same example. So whatever the bubble sort and enter the size of the list, that is the same example only I'm giving. So let me open Spider. Today is October 8th. Okay. So this is the program compared to so C language and Java. Here the logic will be very easy. And whatever the programming we have, you know guys, definitely the logic will be similar. Okay, you have to understand in that way, please. Okay. So let me run this first. Let me run this first. I'm giving four elements. I'm giving like seven. I'm giving eight. I'm giving 10. Oh, I'm giving the correct order. Okay, wait. I'll give different order. Okay, I'll give 4. I'll give 1. Okay, so after sorting, before sorting the elements are 7, 8, 4, 1. After sorting, I'm getting the elements in 1, 4, 7, 8. Okay, here I'm not using any sort method. So, sorted function also, you can check here. So, now let me explain the logic. I'm taking A equal to list. So, A is a, like the array. I'm taking a list. That means A is a variable, like that is a list variable. Here, there is no concept of array, you know already. But array concepts can be covered using a list only, you know that. So I'm taking A equal to list, bubble sort. Just I did displaying bubble sort in the output screen. So you can see here. So it is just displaying bubble sort like this, okay? So it is not necessary actually, but I'm telling like this, okay? So next. N equal to int of input of enter the size of the list. So what is the size of the list I'm giving? 4. So your N equal to 4 now. That means now I'm writing here N equal to 4. The number of elements are 4. That means our loop will be iterated 3 times, you know already, right? So now, enter 4 elements, percentage n. So this is also I have explained earlier. So yesterday also I have given the same values. For I in range of n, what is n? N value is 4. That means I iterates from 0 to 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. It is repeated 4 times. Loop will be repeated 4 times. It will take value equal to, in the first value it is taking like 7. And after that A dot append of value, that means, before sorting, I'm printing A. That means I'm getting 7841. How I'm getting 7841? Because here I'm giving value equal to int of input of. That means it will take the first element as 7. So whenever you're giving 7, A dot append of value means that value will be appended to the list. So what is the list we have? So let me write it here. So A is a list. Now list contains the 4 elements. I'm giving 7 and 8. And 4 and 1. So this is the original list. Okay. So I value will be iterated again. So I already explained yesterday. Once again, I don't want to tell everything. Okay. Because we don't have time. So I put 1. Now again, it will take the first position value, that is 8. And again, it will take 2, 3. So all 2, that means 0 and 2 position, 4 and 1 also will be appended like this. Okay. So now, after that, I'm writing the position here. This is the 0th position because list index always starts from 0. So that's why I'm taking the range from range of n only. If you want to take 1 to, that means 1 comma, you have to write n plus 1. But this is not necessary. But because every list should be started from 0, you know already, right? So list index always starts from 0 to n minus 1. That's the reason I have given only n condition here. Okay? So hope you understand, guys. So according to this rule, the A of 0 position we have 7. And also, you know that whenever you are having a list element, the first element should be stored in A of 0. Now, next element is A of 1. Then second element, A of 1 to. Third element is A of 3 is 1. So, this is the way list is storing. Now, before sorting, that means it is printing A. A means 7841 is appended to the list. So, it is getting like this. Okay. Now, what I am writing this logic, you can see here. So, whatever the logic you are writing here, even in the C language and Java also, you just write a I less than like that, I less than n minus 1 like that. Instead of that, I'm using for I in range of n minus 1. N minus 1 means what is the value of n actually. So n value you know already 4. Here I am already written like this. Now, so 4 minus 1 is 3. 4 minus 1 is 3. But range of 3 stands for, so I value, this is I value, you know already. This is I value, this is ith loop. So I value iterates from 0, 1, 2 only. 3 will not be taken, you know already. Because A of 4 minus 1 stands for I range of 3. Range of 3 stands for it will take 3 elements. That is from 0 to 1 to 2. That's the thing you already know. Why I have given n minus 1 condition? Once again I am telling, in the PPT I clearly mentioned that. Okay, so whenever we have the number of elements are 6, so we have to iterate the values only 5 times because you cannot compare the last element with any other element. That's the reason. Okay, so you can easily check me. For example, this is the list we have 7841. If you want to compare 7 and 8, this is in the correct order. Okay, so again it will check 8 greater than 4. That means 8 is greater than 4, then you need to traverse the you need to swap the 8 and 4. That means again you have to check 4 and 1. That means how many times you are comparing? Only 3 times. That's the reason I have given a condition I in range of n minus 1. This is the way you should understand. Then for j in range of n minus 1, why I have given this condition I will tell you. Okay, so just now I told you guys, so why if I am giving n minus I minus 1 means, first of all let me explain the logic, then I will tell you though, no problem. So j in range of n minus I minus 1, that means here j ranges from n value is 4, guys you already know 4 minus, what is I value initially? I ranges from 0, 3 means it is ranges from 0. So 0, that means 4 minus 0 minus 1. 0, 4 minus 0 minus 1 stands for, 4 minus 0 minus 1 is nothing but 3. That means J also will be iterated 3 times. J also will be iterated 3 times. Now I am giving J value iterated from 0, comma 1, comma 2. Okay? But the first initially we have J value as 0 only. You know that already, right? So here so now the I equal to 0 and J equal to 0. You should remember the values, okay? So 4 minus I minus 1, 0 minus 1. Okay, fine. So everything is fine. So now we'll move to the program concept. It will check. So you already know bubble sort is nothing but it checks the adjacent elements each other. So now here what the condition I am writing? A of j stands for a of 0. What is the value of a of 0? 7. 7 is greater than a of j plus 1. J is 0, 0 plus 1. That is a of 1. A of 1 value is 8 here. You know here. This is a of 0, this is a of 1. Okay. So a of 1 is 8. 7 greater than 8. Condition is false. That means no swapping is done here. Again, it is going back to the inner for loop. Inner for loop. Okay. Now j value removed 0. Now it will start from 1. Okay. So now it will start from 1. Now it will take a of j. A of j value is a of 1. A of 1 is 8. 8 greater than a of 1 plus 1. That means j value is 1. A of 2. What is value of a of 2? That means 4. That means in earlier iteration you are comparing 7 and 8. So there is no swapping done. Then you have to compare with 8 and 4. This is the only bubble sorting, you know already, right? So how the logic is checking like this, you should know completely. So a 8, 4. Now 8 is greater than 4. That means you need to swap the elements with the 4 and 8. So you already know this logic. We need a temporary variable to swap. Of course, Python does not require. I will tell you. Don't please wait, because you have to understand the logic first. That's the reason only I have given a temporary variable like this. Now let me take a temporary variable. Okay. Temporary variable equal to a of j. J value is 1. A of 1. A of 1 value is 8. Temp equal to 8. Next. A of j value is now 1 equal to a of 1 plus 1. A of 1 plus 1 is a of 2. What is the value of a of 2? A of 2 is 4. A of 2 is 4. And then a of j plus 1. That is a of j plus 1 is j value is 1 now. So a of 2 equal to temp. So temp value is 8. So here after this iteration, the list becomes will be changed like 7. A of 1 position 4. And a of 2 position 8. And a of 3 position as usual like 1 only. Now list, you have to take this list from the next iteration. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. You have to remember like this. 0, 1, 2, 3. Next. After that again j value will be incremented. You know already j value first iteration is j value will take like 2. It will check a of 2 greater than a of 2 plus 1. What is the value of a of 2? A of 2 value is 8. 8 is greater than a of 2 plus 1. That is a of 3. What is the value of a of 3? A of 3 is 1. Then again it will swap. So I think you know the logic now. Because temp equal to a of 2, a of 2 equal to a of 3, a of 3 equal to temp. That's all. That means this element will be transferred like, now the list becomes 7, 4, 1, 8. Now the positions are 0, 1, 2, 3. That means now inner iteration is completed. J value 3 up to 3 times completed. So that means now the first iteration is completed. You can check the largest value bubbling to the end. So I am taking the list 7, 8, 4 and 1. So remaining list is unchanged. Till now we have to do the traversing. Okay. So here 8 is going to the correct place. Okay. I think the first iteration is completed, guys. Now, so J iterations are completed. It will going back to the ith iteration. Okay. I iteration 0 is completed. I am removing now. Now I will be taken like 1. Now I am writing here I equal to 1.
So now it will take j in range of n minus I minus 1. N value is 4, I value is 1, 1 minus 1, that means 4 minus 2. That means j equal to 2. J equal to 2 means it will iterate only from 0 and 1 position only. Okay. So now for initially it takes 0. First it compares a of 0, j value is 2 now. Okay. So that means j value 2 means it will start from 0. Okay. So 1 minute, let me erase some lines here. Okay, so now, so j, a of j, that means a of 0, that means a of 0 value is 7 now. We have to consider this list only, okay? 7 greater than a of 0 plus 1, a of 1. What is the value of a of 1? 4. 7 greater than 4. Condition is true absolutely. Now you need to swap temp equal to a of 0, a of 0 equal to a of 1 equal to temp. That means your list will be converted like to 4, 7, 1. 8. Okay, so then j value 2 iteration is completed, that means 0 iteration is completed. Now it will take j value 1 now again. Now after 1, a of j, what is the a of j? A of j value means a of 1 now. Here the positions are now a of 1 is 7. 7 greater than 1. This is a of 1, this is a of 2. Don't confuse guys, please. So 7 is greater than 1, condition is true now. Temp equal to a of 7, that means a of j value is 1, a of 1 stands for, so a of 1 is here, you can check here, a of 1 is 7. So that means again it will swap guys, that's not required actually. So it will swap like 4, 1, 7, 8. Okay. So j iterated only 2 times, now it is completed, now again it is going to ith iteration. How it is not checking the 7 and 8? Because they are already in the correct place. That means why I am giving n minus I minus 1, I think you know, you are able to understand now, right? Because here n minus 1 means, so it will check the 5, if you are having 5 elements, it will check up to 4 times, okay? But here I am giving n minus I minus 1 means, whenever we are completed the first iteration, we don't want to compare with the last element. That means 8 is already there in the correct position. That's the reason I have given I minus 1. This is the way you have to understand. Or you can, in some logic, so many students write that n minus of I plus 1. They will write like this also. But n minus I plus 1 is not good, n minus I minus 1 only. So in that way I am writing here. Okay. So I think hope you understand guys. Now I value becomes again 2. It will take the I value 2 now. Again it will check j value 0. Okay. And before going that, first it will take I value is 2. And how many times loop will be iterated j value? Now I will tell you. N minus I minus 1. N value is 4. I value is 2. 4 minus 2 minus 1. That means 4 minus 3. J value is 1. So j value is 1. J value is 1 in the sense it will iterate only one time. That means j equal to 0 only. J equal to 0 only. So a of j greater than a of j plus 1. This is the list now we have. So that means a of 0 is 4 and 1. That means 4 is greater than 1. Condition true. Again it will swap. So 1, 4, 7, 8. So it will be displayed like this, okay? And after swapping, J iterations are completed and I iterations are also completed. Now after sorting, A will be printed like this. 1, 4, 7, 8. This is nothing but sorting. If you are able to do the sorting with this logic, definitely you can do the smallest element, largest element, and second largest element, second smallest element. The very, very important question in interview point of view, okay? I have seen personally. So second largest and second smallest element are very, very important question actually. But many of the students are doing wrong answer. That's the reason today I would like to explain this concept like bubble sort. And now I will remove these 3 lines. You know already in C language and Java. So you know the power of Python, you already know. So in the same program, if you're writing in C language and Java, you need to do like this in the same way. But there is no swapping required in Python. So instead of T equal to A, so A equal to B, B equal to T. This is the swapping logic actually. You can write only single line. Can you please send in the chat box, guys? Have you remembered that? Anyone? Yes, very good, guys. Many of the students are sending the answer. Thank you. So, thank you, guys. Sharwani, yesterday you were absent. So, take care. No. I'm asking that you have to write a one line, Veni. So I think in the first two classes I told this actually. Okay. So like Sharwani and remaining students also mentioned A comma B equal to B comma A. Okay. A comma B equal to B comma A. This is the sorting technique we have in Python. In single line, we can write like this. A comma B equal to B comma A. That means you have to, what is the A, what is the B here? Then you can change it. Then you can change here. Instead of these three lines, I am writing A equal to like A of J plus 1 equal to, okay? So now you have to write B comma A. That means A of J plus 1 comma A of J. Now I am removing the temporary variables also. That's the reason I have told so many times, very, very important interview question. How many swapping variables are needed to swap two numbers in programming? In real time, it is impossible to swap the two values or to swap the two glasses or whatever it may be. Okay, no problem, Sharwani. Please take care. I think I'm also understanding because you are a regular student. So I'm just telling that I will concentrate on everybody. That's the reason I'm telling. Okay, so next. Okay, so now I'm writing a F J. Come A of J plus 1 equal to A of J plus 1 equal to A of J. Okay, let me clear the drawings. And I am taking 7841, right? So 7841, okay. I am running the same program again. You're getting 1478, okay? So is it possible in this length, is it possible? You can reduce the same code in C and Java? No, it is not possible, guys. It is not possible. In Python, we have a lot of facilities, okay? So, of course, here for adding the two elements, you are writing three lines. In for loop, that means, for example, in C language, you're usually like that, for I equal to 0, I less than I plus plus, scan of percentage, I'm sending day of I. Of course, there may be some problems are there here, but still you can reduce the code using Python, okay? So, this is called bubble sort. I think everybody understanding. So, shall I move to the next concept, please? Confirm your choice, please. Is it okay, guys? So this is bubble sort, guys. Okay, it's very easy, but you are telling that many of the students are telling that bubble sort is very easy to understand. But of course, stick sort, it is like what I have to take a pivot element, how to compare with next element, how it will traverse from I to J. Many students may confuse. They are always thinking that easy concept. Okay, but you should understand, guys, one thing: bubble sort takes so much time. That means time complexity is very, very high. Whereas in the quick sort and merge sort and heap sort, we have only the minimum. Okay, so it is big of n square bubble sort actually, because if you are taking that means four elements or five elements, even though list is in the sorted order. For example, if I am taking 7 and 8, it is comparing still, but in quick sort it not do like that. Okay, it will check only the pivot element, it will compare with the next element or ending element, then it is comparing. So that is very easy. Otherwise, merge sort is very easy because you can split all the values again. You have to merge, and it is very easy. And of course, if sort is also easy. Okay, but compared to remaining techniques, the bubble sort takes a lot of time. Okay, so big of n square is the time complexity, whether it is a best case or a worst case or an average case. Okay, so of course, quick sort also takes the big of n square in the average. Okay, so these are also very important in a special entry of point of view. Remember, guys. Okay. Data structures, time complexities, we will ask in every interviews. Okay, how it will take. And many students know that linear search is easy. So binary search is, they don't know how to do binary search because it may confuse sometimes. But compared to linear search, binary search is very time less. Because in linear search, if you're taking 5 elements, it will take 5 comparisons. If you take 100 elements, it will take 100 comparisons. But binary search will not take that number of comparisons. Okay, data structures concepts are absolutely excellent. I like very, very, very much, especially particular subject. Okay, so I think almost three times I have told that advanced data structures and data structures as well. I know very, very important concepts as well. Okay, so So if you want to get the output, then just after the sorting, if you want to find out the biggest element or smallest, second smallest. And this cannot be possible. For example, if you want second largest number, here we have to write a of n minus 2. Here you can make a of minus 2 also, you can write like this, okay? Second smallest is. So you can see here, I'm giving the 6 elements, 78, 45, 98, 25, 11, 36. I'm getting 11, 25, 36, 45, 78, 8, 98. So if I give, if in interviews, if they are asking the second smallest and second largest, I am telling guys, so this is the very easy programming. So whenever you have C, Python and Java, you should prefer Python because it is very easy in Python. Okay, you can reduce the length of the code. And whenever you're writing, you don't know how some rules in programming. While taking the online tests in any companies like TCS and all, okay, they will know how much time you are spending the particular problem. They will maintain that record also. You don't know that, okay? So if you submit the same code, if they are giving 25 minutes of time for solving a particular problem, if you are doing within 10 minutes, you will get awarded. That means you will get a more value compared to them. They know everything, how much time you are spending. Okay, so please guys, hope you understand now. So here you can see the second largest is 78, okay, the second smallest is 25. It is easily getting like this. Okay, so if you're using this program, I think it is the best way. Okay, so of course, and shall we move to the next concept? In according to the syllabus, the next topic we have Python modules. Okay, so but actually in syllabus they have mentioned clearly, so standard modules. What is nothing but a standard modules? We already discussed it actually. Okay, so I have already given the notes also. I don't want to waste much time about this concept, but I will tell you how far it will be useful for the concepts. Okay, so here you can see, so we are entered into the last concept of unit 3. This is the concept we have to cover. Okay, so far we completed these concepts. So now let me move to the modules. So I think one more thing I would like to ask you guys. Just now I did bubble sort program. You are able to do with remaining sorting technique also, you can do. Okay, of course it is not in the syllabus, but you should do. I will give an assignment like selection sort. Okay, you have to do. In that way you should complete, guys, please. Okay, and let me take a modules concept. Here they given completely like standard modules. But we can define our own modules also in Python. I have already explained what are the standard modules we have. So we know that one of the module we have math. So in math module, if you are giving that, explain the different modules or explain the module concept in detail. If you are getting the question like that, you can take this math, you can give lot of examples, okay? Because you know the functions in the math, you have a lot of functions like GCD, factorial, square root, power, okay, cos, sine, tan. Okay, so round, trunk, we have a lot of things we have already discussed. Okay, you can check with the notes. Okay, so but I will tell you how to create a module by own. I will tell you that concept because they did not mention anything in syllabus, but let me explain how to create a module. Okay, and modules plays a major role. Why I am giving math? For example, there is no square root symbol in our keyboard, but still, how could we perform like square root operation? Right, that means we are having a math module inbuilt function, that means inbuilt module we have. So that's the reason square root is an inbuilt function, we are calculating the same. But inside, whenever you are running the program by using any editor like Spider or Jupyter Notebook, whatever it may be, that means whatever the code you are writing, inside math module body is there. That means whatever the libraries, whatever the packages we have to execute the square root function, it is already installed. That's the reason we are getting square root of 5, square root of 4 means then immediately we are getting 2 like this. Okay, that means inbuilt logic is already there. It was already developed by developers itself. That's why it is called as a built-in functions. Okay, so like square root and power, these are called as built-in functions. But now let me create a how to create a module. And I already promised to you yesterday. I will tell you some funny things today. I already told you guys. And I will before going to explain how to create a module. Let me explain. How to that means you know packages. I think many of the students know third and final years about Java. So creating packages and all. Package is nothing but for example for any software developers, if you want to create a game, first you have to create a package. That means whatever the functions, whatever the modules we have, that will be completely there in the package itself. Then they will release the particular game or any app, whatever it may be. That means they will define like some predefined we have. Okay, let me explain. I think many of the students I know, I already gone through some websites also. We have 2-3 lines of code to download YouTube files and all. Okay, everything, because you know, for example, I am opening a YouTube like this. Okay, so you know that how YouTube will be useful for us. Okay, you know everything, I think, guys. Because YouTube is a biggest repository we have. Okay, so here I'm giving like here I'm, it is like a kids short videos I'm giving like this. Okay, I hope you are able to see my screen. Now I'm just copying the link. Okay, I'm just copying the link. So here it is just like a because of time consuming purpose I'm taking a short video. It is just 2 hours, 2 minutes, 42 seconds, 42 minutes, okay, 242 seconds, okay. So this is the video, I think, not 242, 1 minute, let me start it from here. Okay, yes, only, 2 minutes, 42 seconds, okay. Let me close this. Are you getting voice? Are you getting voice? That means video voice. Okay. My mic is there, right? So anyway, I think many of the students don't know how to download YouTube videos. Okay, so I think many of the students don't know. So I will tell you, in Python we have a lot of concepts. So here that means we have to install some packages before that. So let me open, you know, what is a module and package. Before that, I would like to tell about PIP. What is a PIP? I will tell you first of all. Okay, PIP install. This is the very important command here in Python. So PIP stands for, here I am telling, Python package index. Okay, Python package index. Okay, for example, I would like to download a YouTube video. Okay, so if you would like to download a YouTube video, so if you download that in your YouTube application, okay, in your application, it will not be downloaded into your mobile. You know that already, right? So that means it will be downloaded only in downloads folder, and that means downloads app in the particular YouTube app, you know already, right? So but for example, if you want to download and if you want to put any status in your WhatsApp, then you need to download, because if you just type the WhatsApp status on love, I think you're just typing in that the message, you will get lot of videos in YouTube itself. If you want to download that, you can easily download here. So by using the Python, okay. Before going that, first you should install. That means I am telling here Anaconda. Just type Anaconda, okay. So just type Anaconda prompt. Just type Anaconda prompt. So you just click on this. If you are having Spider in your system itself, you just take Anaconda, okay. Anaconda prompt. Just it will show like this. C:\Kumar. Okay, now first of all, I would like to send the feedback form. 1 minute, please wait. So after completion of the class, please guys, so definitely all of you fill this details. Okay, so here I am taking a 1 minute. PIP install PyTube. I'm just sending into your chat box also. Okay, so here PYP install PyTube. That means just you have to click, you have to just paste here. Okay, the PyTube is this is nothing but packages actually. That means here some predefined packages we have in Python. if you just click on enter, so those will be installed automatically. It will take around 2-3 minutes. That's all. That's not a problem at all. I don't want to enter because I already installed. Because before going to explain the concepts, I usually prepare the concepts, right? So you just type that command pip install pytube. Okay. So now I am writing a code. Now I am writing a code to download the YouTube videos. Okay. Now I am copying this. Okay, that means you need to copy the code. That means you need to copy the URL which file you want to download. Okay, which video you want to download. I am just adding here. So first of all, before running the program, you must save the program. Because why I am telling? Because I am running the program in the category of C users. So Spider 3 my programs like this. Okay, here it is untitled. Because the downloaded file will be there in the particular my programs folder, okay? So you should save definitely, okay? So 1 minute, let me clear the drawings and let me save the program. Okay, so first of all, I would like to open my folder. So in users folder, Kumar is there, and after Spider Py3 in my programs. Okay, so I have already downloaded 2 videos. Whether it is working or not, I am just downloading 2 videos. I will remove this. Okay, so you can see here there is no files there. So let me open Spider. I already saved my program, guys. I have written from PyTube. Why I am giving PyTube? PyTube is just now I told you. So this is a package. This is a package we already installed. Import YouTube. YouTube means here you are giving import math. Math is a module. Here YouTube is a module. Okay, so let me run this code how it will works or not. Okay. So based of, for example, now the time is, everybody see, guys, you can watch my time also. Okay, so now the 6:23:57 seconds, and now 6:24. Okay, exactly. So now I am running the code. Oh, why happened? So 1 minute, guys. Actually, I created some modules concept also. I think reloaded modules are there. 1 minute. Okay, it is downloading. That's not a problem at all. You can see here, it is getting CGI animated short video. Okay. So now this time is 6:24. It is 0 KB. You can see here, it is 0 KB. Okay. But it is still downloading. Just wait for a second, 1 minute. Because at least you have to download video also, you should wait at least 2-3 minutes, right? Of course, it depends upon your internet speed as well. Okay, it is downloaded, guys. So 6871 KB. Okay, so it is their CGI animated short film. Okay, so whatever the picture you are getting here. So you can see, okay. Okay, so let me close this and I will open the downloaded video. So within 1 minute it is downloaded, right? It was not downloaded within 1 minute, right? So you can see. So I will. I think, are you able to listen now? Are you able to listen video song, video sound? Yes. It was downloaded, guys. These are the excellent features we have. I think Sushma already know. Sushma already go through with some websites and Instagram also, right? So it is. It was downloaded. You're getting a lot of videos. You can download anything. Okay, you can do the same. Let me close this, guys. Okay, so that means within one minute, it is getting like this. 24 I started, like 6:25 I'm downloading this. Okay, so in this way you can do like this, guys. Okay, so I'm explaining this code now. So video downloaded successfully. Okay, it is getting this message from PyCube. That means usually we have like from operator or whatever it may be. We have already from mad import. Okay, star. We are always used to give like this, right? For example, it will get all the mathematical modules. So you can download. That's not a problem. So that means you have to whatever Monica you are asking. So that means you have to work with some. For example, I'm telling. Yeah, but means you have to. You are using like a mobile means. I think I did not check it actually, but you should try. Okay, you should try, guys. Please, and I did not check it actually, but it is an excellent feature we have. That means here, what is the syntax? I will tell you guys. So here, whatever the link you want to specify, you have to specify here. Streams dot first download. These are the inbuilt methods only. I did not have that much. That means, for example, these are not developed by me itself. Okay. So here, YouTube module is there. By YouTube module, you are giving a link dot streams. That means streams means whatever the by default stream. For example, you know that. So you can view the video using 360 pixel, 480 pixel like that. Okay. By default, the uploaded video which will be there in which pixel mode. So I think you are getting a good clarity also. Okay. So it can be downloaded like this. This is the method we have. And let me, here I will give these three lines in your chat box also, because I don't want to specify in the notes. Okay, you just copy. So first you should give from PyCube import star. You can also give import star also. That's not a problem at all. And YouTube link streams first download. And I would like to tell you one more thing, guys. For example, if you are here, that means within a single line, you are downloading the program, right? So it is required in internet actually, because you are downloading from external server, right? In that way, you can also find. For example, usually whenever you are having interviews, so sometimes they will ask your image in PDF format. For example, let me take my image, okay? So or sometimes so your certificates also should be uploaded to your particular companies through PDF format. Okay, so many of the students open that. So how to convert a given Word file into PDF file. So many students just like that, just Google it, or they can use like Cam Scanner app. Okay, so it will be the photo. Whenever you're taking a photo, then it will be automatically converted like a PDF file. And some students may think like that JPEG to PDF converter, they will download that file actually. That software also. Okay, so JPG to PDF converter, we have some like smallpdf.com, ilovepdf.com, we have some website. Okay, if you are uploading a JPG file, it will be converted into PDF. I think many of the students know about this. Okay, so but I will tell you, we have one more program, so we can convert the code easily. That means whatever the image you have, that will be converted to PDF with using Python. Okay, with using Python. So for example, let me write this logic as well. First of all, I would like to take my photo. So first of all, I'm taking my photo. I'm just pasting into my program. That means whatever the program's location I have, I'm pasting here. Okay, so now here you can see my name, Kumar, is there. It is in the JPG format. You can click on the right side properties button and you will get so JPG, this is JPG file. That means here it is my image there. Okay, so now let me open Spider. So whatever the program I have explained, you can also do in this way also as well. Okay, from Python, import YouTube. Importing YouTube from PyTube. That is PyTube is a package. Okay, and so asking user to enter the link. You can also enter the link like this. Input enter your link. Then you can give YouTube link dot. That means instead of double quotes, you can give in this way also. You can run the program, you can give the link in the runtime also. Then it will display print downloading. After that, video downloaded successfully. It is also a good program, I think so. Okay. So if you want it, I will send in the chat box. But before going to run the program, you need to install the package. That should be compulsory. That should be compulsory. Okay. So let me wait here. To convert the JPG to PDF, you just only one time you can install the packages, okay? So here one predefined packages are there. PHP install pillow. I am writing here PHP install, okay? P is capital letter, pillow, okay? So PHP install pillow. I am just writing like this, okay? So this is the package we have. So whenever you are taking this command, after pressing enter, so it will take almost 5 minutes time to download those packages, okay? Because inbuilt we have only math module and all, okay? You can download any packages and you can run the programs like this, okay? So let me copy this code and I will open a new window, okay? So I'm saving. So this program will convert my photo into PDF format, okay? You can convert the any certificates also, like SSC certificate, inter certificate also, you can convert, okay? Let me take like the file name like PIC, okay? Here I am writing only 4 lines code. I will tell you the explanation, don't worry. And I am taking the kuma.jpg. This file name should be matched with whatever the image we have. So kuma.jpg, it is there here. You can check. So kuma.jpg you have in the given folder. That means whatever the programs I am running the folder. So that is the path I already explained just now. So kuma.jpg file is there here. Okay. Now I am converting the given image into PDF format. And for this, actually, if you are doing like with internet, you have to download. Here it is, I love PDF, I am giving JPG to PDF. But still it is not reaching. Sometimes you may get these errors, right? Without internet also, you can convert the given image, you can convert into PDF format. That means PDF is nothing but portable document format, okay? So let me run this code. Here, once again, I am telling PIL. Here, from math, that means math is a module. Here I am giving PIL is a shortcut for pillow. So here it is a predefined. So and import image. Instead of image, you can give import star also. That's not a problem at all. So let me run this code. Okay. So now the time is 6:33. You can check here. Output is coming. Already downloaded. Okay. That means whenever it is, this line is getting, that means our program is successfully completed. Now you can see, now the time is 6:33. Okay. So Kumar will be converted into PDF. Acrobat Radar. This is JPG file. So within 1 minute, without internet connection also. You don't need internet connection for this program actually. So now I am opening my Kumar folder, that means Kumar PDF file. So if it is there, my photo is there inside, our program is successful. Okay? That means this is PDF file. So this is my image. You can see this is called PDF. So how it is, guys? I'm not asking about my photo. I'm asking about the program. Awesome. Very good. Yes. You can see the code. I don't want to explain, right? So you can see the code. Definitely you can understand. So this is the 3 lines code. This is the 3 lines code. Okay. This is the 3 lines code we have. So why Python is very important nowadays? This is the reason, guys. This is the reason. Okay. So thank you very much for your compliments in the chat box. Thank you very much, guys. But I am not the developer for this. Okay. The Python developers are developing this code. That means you can have the package. Like I have seen some websites, COVID package is also there. COVID package. So what is the purpose of COVID package? So you just install the COVID package by using the Anaconda's prompt. Then after that, you are just writing a program. Whatever the cases we have, it will be displayed on the state wise. It is also there. So that means the developers are thinking in that way. Okay. So where we stand, you have to know. Here I am writing. So this is the only import statement you know already, guys. Image I is a capital letter, must be. Image one is a variable name. You can take any variable name. That's not a problem at all. image dot open. Here image is a predefined like math, like this. Okay, if you are giving star, it can give automatically, it will get. Open is a predefined method. Okay, so R means root, because my picture is there in this root, it will automatically roots to the particular location. In Unix, usually called as root is a Can you hear me, guys? Can you hear me? Yeah. So, sorry, guys. Suddenly, my internet was struck. So, why it happened, I don't know. Sorry, guys. Thank you very much. So what is I'm explaining about RGB, right? So you can see here. Here, IMG1.convert, that means whatever the color photos we have, usually in electronic format, RGB is a predefined format we have. If you want to Google it also, you can just Google it. I'm just writing like Google. I'm writing like 1 minute. So RGB colors. It is taking a lot of time, guys. Okay, so you can see here RGB is the color scheme that is associated with electronic displays such as CRT, LCD monitors, digital cameras in color mode actually. Okay, RGB stands for red, green and blue. That means here whenever you are taking like RGB means your color photo will be converted. So that means it will be in the color mode only. It will be converted like RGB format. Okay, and save means that file name should be saved with Kumar. So whatever the here it is, the PDF file is also there. So whatever the location in your file contains, so that will be saved. That means here IM1 is a variable, you can take like A. Here you can take like A. That's not a problem at all. You can take anything. That's not a problem at all. Okay. So but for this program, you don't need an internet connection also. You don't need internet connection also. Okay. So 1 minute, let me copy this code. I will send this anyway. And instead of that, you can convert anything. Okay. So try to use the spider module or the notebook also, okay? Because you are using a decoder application like that, whether it will works or not, I don't know actually, okay? So I'm sending the same, okay? So you can check. And once again, I will send the feedback form link. So these are the concepts I did not discuss in the material, okay? That's the reason I have sent in your chat box. Hope you understand. Or otherwise, you can... just take a screenshots. Okay, so just now I told that means here how I am creating PAL, how I am importing image. That means we can also import our own modules. That's the topic I have to cover actually. So I have prepared everything, Python module, how to create. So I think almost 6:40 now. So anyway, tomorrow I will explain, guys. So these are the very useful programs we have in. You can Google it. That's not a problem at all. You can Google it. Lot of programs we have. within 2-3 lines itself, we can easily done. Okay. Hope you understand, guys. Thank you, one and all. If you have any doubts, I will be here 2-3 minutes. Okay. If you have any more questions, you can ask. So otherwise, you can leave the session. Thank you very much. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you very much, Khanna. It's good to learn new things from you. It's not from you. So, sir, from tomorrow we have classes from 5:30 to 7:30. Wow! What happened, Monica? You are the regular student. You are telling this. Is it APSSDC? Shall I take leave 10 days for your examinations purpose? But our secondary students may trouble because they like my teaching. So, is it, guys? Second year students, shall I take the leave 10 days? No, sir. Everybody is saying no, sir. I'm getting a lot of messages. Thank you. Thank you. So, they are not agreed. How can I then? But many, I'm also troubling the same, actually. Because some students are having training classes and third year students are having mid examinations from Monday onwards. And I'm also thinking the same. But I don't know what I have to do. But here only we have 2 units. But I'm telling a different concept because of how Python is very important in our life. So that's what I'm telling, actually. But you don't want to miss the Python class. Then what should I do, Monica? So, I will send the recordings anyway. That's not a problem at all, okay? That's the reason I'm creating a YouTube, right? But nobody is liking. Okay, many students are happy. I'm very happy, guys, because this is called programming, guys. Because so you should prepare like this. You can develop a new package. It's not a problem at all. You can how the people are developing a COVID package. So within this duration, that is programming. You can also define module means we can define a new module also. That's the reason I have to cover this topic because they given in the syllabus. Only standard module. Standard is nothing but predefined. But I would like to tell you how to create a module. If I'm telling that concept, you can define a new package, you can define a game, you can develop any application, whatever you want. Okay? So anyway, I will see tomorrow. Happy, guys. I'm also very happy from today. I think you don't know. Almost 7 hours, my laptop was in switched on mode. I'm also on the same system. Okay? So I'm experimenting with all the things. And I have another example also. You can check in the Google itself. You can send WhatsApp SMS to you by using Python with 3 lines, with 2 lines of code. Okay, you can sleep at that time also. Okay, so it will go automatically, but it is some drawbacks are there. That's the reason I don't want to discuss, because many students may misuse that. Okay, that's the reason I don't want to discuss, actually. So anyway, thank you very much, all of you. Thank you, Monica. Thank you, Devi. Thank you. Really, really, I have tired today. Okay, almost 7 hours. You don't know because I have practiced everything. How it is downloading, how it is the code will works. So, I had downloaded another file also, actually. So, it was also done successfully. Even 5 minutes video also, 10 minutes video also, 50 minutes video also. You can download anything. You can put a lot of status today. Okay, you can download anything, whatever you want from YouTube. YouTube is the biggest repository we have. So happy, guys. Everybody, please stay home, stay happy, stay safe. Bye-bye.